Aloha, this is Evangelist Ricky Calderon, broadcasting again to you from Kailua Kona on the Big Island of Hawaii at 4 p.m. every Sunday and 7 p.m. on the West Coast, 10 p.m. on the East Coast. So join us again for the continuation of Charles Darwin's theory of evolution. Is it fact? Is it fiction? Where is the proof? Do you believe you come from monkeys? So we're dedicating this program to several people here. YWAM people. I met a Sarah and her group at Costco a few days ago. And who else here? We have Kim and Dick. They're in Florida. Also, Martha. Pray for Martha. She has three kids and pregnant. Pray that she gets saved. Also, Antonio in Florida. And we've got here John, who suffered a stroke, Sarah's dad, and also Vivian. So join us, and as we sing the Somewhere Over the Rainbow, the theme song, but pray for these people. I'll have needs, please. And again, like and subscribe, and we'll go into the meat of the program. Right after this here, we're going to go into the song Somewhere Over the Rainbow, God's Up High, and the Prayers Whom You Prayed For Are Heard in Paradise. Or Somewhere Over the Rainbow, That's Where Angels Fly, and the Prayers Whom You Prayed For Are Heard in Paradise. So join me as we sing the theme song here, Song of Hope. Always heard in paradise. You may not think so. I thought that way one time too, but I was thick-headed and didn't want to believe what God was doing. So don't be like me. Have faith. I had faith, but I went a little too far past the faith in my book. So anyway, here's a joke or a little bit of humor for the day. Okay, God does have humor. Look around you at your relatives, and they look at me and go, oh, God has humor for you too. Anyway, this has to do with COVID. I know we're just getting over it, but this is what the statement has to do about. Another Saturday night in the house, and I just realized even the trash goes out more than me. How true that was. How true that was. So we have a little bit of humor. We had to stay in the house. And here is the scripture which I gave you a couple of weeks ago now. And this one here, again, I'm getting this right out of the Bible. I'll read it. It says here, and God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. This is Genesis 1:26. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and over the cattle and over all the earth and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. Genesis 1:26. So it said, let us. Now, what do you think us could be? He didn't say let me, let us. That's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That's us. Hello. That's where we get that from. All right, we're going to continue where we left off. Again, I'm leaving or using this book here. Doesn't evolution make creation obsolete? This is where this is coming from, right here. I'll tell you, I found a juicy bit of information here about how old is the universe? Unbelievable. It's so much of it makes so much sense that we don't even realize. And basically, this is what this is about. I mean, I love Planet of the Apes. I mean, I think it's cool. This is Caesar from Planet of the Apes. But God said, let us make them in our image. Now, God was not a monkey or an ape, a gorilla, a chimpanzee. Sorry, we are made in the image and likeness of God, period. All right, so here we go. All right. It is clear that the question as to whether process of random mutation, natural selection, can reasonably account for all of the many kinds of plants and animals that exist, as well as all the various parts and biological functions, remains unsolved. This is why it's called a theory of evolution. And some of the more common concerns about creation are, with the Bible indicating that the earth is only 6 to 12,000 years old, based on the six-day Genesis account of creation, and the state of lifespans of those individuals listed or related to the genealogy from Adam to Jesus, why would the various geological dating techniques seem to indicate that the earth is more than 4.5 billion years old? The Bible and the carbon dating simply do not line up. It's again, they mention all the creatures that God created, the birds, the bees, the insects, the mammals, plants. If you average 10,000 years per species, and there's thousands and thousands of species, there's simply not enough time in 4.5 billion years for all of this to have happened. You need much more time than 4.5 billion years. But that goes outside of the theory of evolution. That's why it's called a theory. It's not provable. So here we have false fact number one. Now, here is Mary talking about Jesus, and there was a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and she said this, whatever he says to you, do it. This is his mother Mary saying this, all right? Now, basically, they ran out of wine, and the wine they had then was not the wine we think of today, by the way. It was totally different. They simply did not have the manufacturing processes to create the wine that you know of today. What they call wine then was called oinos, which is basically grape juice, okay? So that's what they call wine way back then, but to say it's the same wine as today is totally false. So here's the rest of the story. Some out now and take it to the head waiter, and they took it to him. So again, they ran out of wine, and they had big vases filled with water. When the head waiter tasted the water, which had become wine, Jesus changed the water into wine and did not know where it came from. But the servants who had drawn the water knew. The head waiter called the bridegroom. This is John 2, 1 through 11. The Bible also states, and a certain one of them struck the slave of the high priest. Okay, they're giving another story here. They're going to combine these two. And a certain one of them struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his right ear, but Jesus answered and said, stop, no more of this. And he touched his ear and healed him. This is Luke 22, 50 through 51. Therefore, since it takes time to make wine, and since it takes time for severed body parts to be reattached and healed, although Jesus did each instantaneously, it is clear that God, through Jesus in these particular instances, has the ability to create things or perform processes that appear to be old when they actually are not. Wow, that's a very powerful statement. So here is God creating wine instantly from water, okay? it usually takes, you know, a while for the wine to be created, but instantly, okay, built in time. I never thought of that. There it is. It's in the Bible. And then the other one was the servant of the high priest. I think I read the Bible. I could be wrong on this, but Peter was the one that supposedly chopped his ear off. But Jesus said, stop, and he immediately reattached it. I mean, according to our standards today, for that ear to have healed would take months and months and months. Rehabilitation, stitches, transfusions. Jesus healed it instantly. It had built-in time, which goes back to what they're saying. 4.5 billion years old, the earth was created. And again, is that enough time for all species to have evolved according to evolution? That's false, totally false. So, here we go. All right. So again, here's the important point. Why would God have to wait billions and billions of years or thousands and thousands of years when all-knowing and omnipotent God, all-powerful, could simply speak it into existence? So for man to say God would wait billions of years is totally ludicrous, is the word. It's ridiculous. It doesn't happen. All-powerful God has to wait thousands and thousands of billions of years. False again. False. All right. Now, here's what the evolutionists are afraid of. If we could prove the existence of a supreme being or God, then our entering into relationship with him that he wants and has made possible for us would no longer be completely free and voluntary. Okay? We would, to at least some degree, feel obligated to comply with his wishes as a result of our coming to realize that we are in a subordinate position to his supremacy. And a lot of these people believe in evolution, do not want to bow their knee to an all-powerful being. They don't want to admit they are sinners, that they are wrong. And that's, I'm sorry, but it's in Revelation. I don't remember the exact spot, but there's even music too. Every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. You have no choice, but you will be bowing your knee to the creator of the universe, of all things, as we know it. So, heed my word. Check out the scriptures. Therefore, it makes perfect sense that God will now allow his existence to be actually proven by us through proving that the earth is really very young and therefore must have been created by a supreme being until sometime after we have freely and voluntarily entered into the relationship with him that he wants and has made possible for us. So God didn't just, you know, lay it all out on the table and say, here it is. No, he wants us to think, make a choice, and use our brains. Okay, God gave us brains to make a choice. Even the Aborigines, the Hawaiians, the Polynesians, they knew this could not have been created by accident. Even the Indians, the gray white spirit, there's too much organization to all of this have happened from a big bang. If there's a big bang, first off, there's no sound in outer space, so you hear no bang, number one. Number two, there is too much order. Even scientists say this, to have this have been created by a big bang, by an explosion, it would cause disorder. God is not a God of disorder. He's a God of order. The author of confusion is Satan, okay? He wants us to believe in a big bang because there would be so much disorganization that would say, hey, there's no such thing as a God, okay? But there is. So here we are. So this issue need not remain as a concern about creation. It is clear that God has the ability to give the appearance of age to things that are not old. And since it would have been reasonable for God to have done so in the case of the earth in order to keep our freedom to enter or not enter into a relationship with him intact. So God creates things with built-in age. And I give you two examples. The wedding at Cana. And also the other one where the servant of the high priest had his ear chopped off. All right. Now this one. This ties in beautifully. How old is the universe? So, do we have foolish fables or scientific facts? Some things your professor didn't mention. We're going through this brochure here, okay? And I'm telling you, some of the stuff I read here makes so much common sense. And I almost majored in geology, by the way. I love geology, rocks and all that kind of stuff. So here we go. How old is the universe? Now, evolutionists generally use five different methods to determine the age of matter. Salt content in the oceans, the deposition of sediments, the rate of soil erosion, disintegration of radioactive materials, Libby's carbon-14 experiment. Now, those are the methods that they utilize to find out how old something is. Problems can be found with all of these methods, especially when one factors in the Genesis flood, which they don't like to do. The evolutionists have ignored a sixth method, the study of half-lives. The study of half-lives is where one figures the current rate of decay or deterioration of something and then figures backwards to see how long this process could have been going on. Naturally, this allows one to estimate an approximate age for the thing being studied. For example, if a man's odometer doesn't work on his car, he can still figure approximately how far he has traveled if he knows how many miles his car will run in a gallon of gasoline. So, it is feasible. Now, basically, we have a threat to religious conviction that the universe is over 4.5 billion years old, if you want to believe that. And the rest of these facts will just simply blow away evolution. And it's sort of sad the majority of the public does not know this. I didn't know this either. How big was the sun anyway? The sun is constantly burning at a rate of about 5 feet per hour. This means, bear with me here, sun decreases over 43,000 feet in size per year. That's a lot of footage. That's over 8 miles per year or 800 miles per century. Only 100,000 years ago, the sun would have been twice its current size. So see, if you want to believe in evolution, this fact here blows it away because it doesn't follow logically what the evolutionists believe is true. It's like they're following their own religion, which is a false religion. Looking back to only 20 million years, the sun would have been large enough to touch the earth and burn it to a crisp. Wow. So, okay, if you want to believe evolution and go by it and check it out scientifically, the facts are here. Evolution simply does not work, people. I mean, as much as you want to believe you're a monkey, I'm sorry. And again, I'll say this. If any of you people out there believe you come from monkeys, email me and I'll gladly send you a basket full of bananas. And I guarantee once you bite into it, you will go ape. Bad. Oh, well, that's free too. But I love Planet of the Apes. But as far as saying that's the truth, it's not. All right. Interplanetary dust, D-U-S-T. Listen to this. 14 million tons per year lands on the earth. If the universe is 4.5 billion years old, okay, as the evolutionists claim, then there should be over 500 feet of space dust on the moon. Wow, over 500 feet. In fact, before man landed on the moon, many scientists expressed fears of the astronauts sinking into hundreds of feet of dust. Isaac Asimov said, I get a picture, therefore, of the first spaceship picking out a nice level place for landing purposes, coming in slowly, downward tail first, and sinking majestically out of sight. Now, Isaac Asimov has written numerous science fiction novels. I love his writing, excellent artist. He's a writer. He's dead, though. When the astronauts landed, this is what they found. Less than an inch of dust was present. This amount could have been accumulated only a few thousand years. So this backing up what the Bible says, 6 to maybe 11,000 years that the Earth is old in age, okay? The genealogy, Adam begat, and there's a lot of begatting. And I totaled that. I came up a little over 11,000 years myself, but I kept adding all the years these people lived, and then they begatted someone over here. Seth begatted someone over there. It's not billions and billions of years. So that's a complete theory. It's a big fat lie. Now, even astronomically, Sirius, the red star. And I'll stick this on the screen again. I'm not making this up. Here it is, right here. Okay, Sirius, the red star. So, listen to this. This will blow you away. Okay. Modern scientists who believe in evolution teach at least 100,000 years are required for a red giant star to change into a white dwarf. 100,000 years. Sirius is clearly a white dwarf today, but only 2,000 years ago, astronomers recorded that Sirius was a red star. Gee, they're wrong again. Where did the 100,000 years go? It only took 2,000. Another lie. Lie upon lie. I mean, if you want to believe their lies, be my guest. But if you have any common sense, you will not believe the lies and be duped by these people. Why then does Sirius evolve from a red giant to a white dwarf in only 2,000 years? That's a good question. So somehow or other, 98,000 years was chopped off. Another evidence of built-in time that God did. Next question, how far to the moon? Each year the moon recedes a few inches further from the Earth, going back a few thousand years. This would only place the moon less than 1 mile closer to the Earth. However, calculating back over 4.5 billion years, the moon would be so close to the Earth that the tides would have eroded away the continents. What? No, see, they're just saying things without proving it scientifically. Do not believe their hogwash. Can they prove it or they can't? It's a theory. Next one. The Earth's magnetic field. Less than 100,000 years ago, our magnetic field would have been stronger than the sun. That's less than 100,000 years. Imagine it would have been like 4.5 billion years ago. Wow. So less than 100,000 years ago, scientifically, the magnetic field of the Earth would have been stronger than the sun. That's less than 100,000 years ago. Now imagine 4.5 billion years. I mean, we'd be able to attract major planets, Jupiter. It's crazy, crazy. Here's another lie. the population problem here. Why are there only, well, at this time this was written, 6 billion people. I believe we're up to 8 billion people now on the earth. Now, in just a few thousand years, since 1900, the earth's population rose from about 3 billion to 6 billion. And again, it's now up to 8 billion, 2023. If men have been the earth for millions of years, why isn't the population at least a trillion? Maybe because the flood wiped out all the sinners. That's something to think about. So again, if the earth is 4.5 billion years old, why is there only 8 billion people? According to this, if they were 4.5 billion years old, the earth, there should be a trillion people, and yet there's only 8 billion. And then they're squawking about, oh, there's no room, and another lie upon lie. There's plenty of room here on the earth. And, Elon Musk is trying to go to Mars. I applaud him for that. And I don't think it would hurt for us to expand humanity to other planets safely. Because the way things are looking, you get a lot of problems. Radiation, bone marrow, disorientation, eye loss. I put that in my book I wrote, science fiction book. So hopefully it will be coming out this year, hopefully. All right, moving on. High-speed planet. The spin cycle of the Earth is gradually slowing down, so it has historically spun faster. The further back one calculates, the faster the Earth spins. A few thousand years back doesn't present a problem, but a few million years would have the planet spinning so fast it would have spun itself into a flat pancake. I don't know about you, but I like IHOP because they make awesome pancakes there, but to have the Earth do that, not a wise idea. Other considerations. If the Earth is 4.5 billion years old, then why does ocean floor sediment account for only a few thousand years? The oldest living coral reef is less than 4,200 years old. The fact that the Genesis flood occurred around 4,400 years ago would have killed all such life forms. Okay, I can barely read that one there. Genesis flood washed out all the trees less than 5,000 years ago. Wow. Okay, I'm right on course here. Let me see if I can wrap this up. Okay, Rick records this. Okay, 6,000 years of humans. Like, okay, here we are. Okay, a biblical creation has no problem, only 6,000 years of records, because it's precisely the amount of time accounted for in the Bible. How can evolutionists explain this? They can't. Okay, short-term communists demands that we'd be totally dissipated in about 10,000 years. How could short-term comets be billions of years old when they're totally gone in about 10,000 years? The evidence is overwhelmingly in support of a young universe. Those who claim otherwise, regardless of their education, are living in a dreamland, a dream world. These people have made up their minds to make a liar out of God in order to escape accountability to him. Don't you fall for their deception. Get a King James Bible and read it daily. So that's this brochure here. I finished it. How old is the universe? Very educational. Okay. And again, if you missed anything, YouTube saves them. We will continue next week about Darwin's dominoes. Right here, Darwin's dominoes. It's quite a bit of information here about evolution and creation. So we will enlighten everyone about the facts other than the theories. And that's what we're doing here. That's why we have this program. And other times we'll be going over world religions. What do you believe? What are you supposed to believe if you're part of this religion? And what's God's word say about it? And lastly, put this up here. Okay. Oh, yeah. I remember this here. This is good. I heard this on Pastor Jack Gibbs on the CSN network. He said, you go from goo to zoo to you. I mean, they said we had not enough time. This is outrageous. And don't forget this. Revelation. I'm going to have a revolution here. Revelation 21:8. Liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone. As we speak, Charles Darwin is burning in hell. Okay, so keep your eyes up. Jesus, heck, would come back soon. He's come back now. Everything's in place. So join me as we sing the theme song and end the program. Tune in next week, same time, 4 p.m. in Hawaii, 7 p.m. on the West Coast, and 10 p.m. on the East Coast. So we'll sing the final song here, Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Join me as we end the program. One day I prayed to God above, wake up where the clouds are all around me, where problems melt like lemon drops, high above the mountain tops, that's where you find me, somewhere over the God's up high, and the prayers whom you pray for are heard in paradise. All right, so again, join me next week, same time. 4 p.m. in Hawaii, 7 p.m. West Coast, 10 p.m. on the East Coast. If you miss them, YouTube saves them all. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you next week. Aloha.